Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. This is a part of training learning with JavaScript with ServiceNow. So the next topic is conditions. Let's see what is the conditional statements in JavaScript. Conditional statement is used to perform with any action on the basis of conditions in JavaScript. We have a conditional statement like if, in which code is executed if condition is true. We have a else if condition in which code is executed if another condition is true, and then we have a switch in which multiple block of code is executed alternatively on the basis of the expression's value. Starting with the if condition, the syntax if statement is you write if keyword, then you put conditions in bracket, then you put curly brackets and that is opening and closing curly bracket, and within those you write the code which you want to execute when the condition is true. Next is else. The syntax of else statement is you write else keyword, then you put opening and closing bracket. In this case you don't need to put any condition, so in else statement you don't need to put any condition like we did it before if statement, and within the curly brackets you write the code which you want to execute when condition is false. So if you will write if and else together, then the code will look like this, in which the first code will be executed with if condition is true. So if we have a first condition is if it is true, then action 1 will be taken. That means the code which is basically written in action 1 that will be executed. Else if that condition is not true, in that case else statement will run, the code in action 2 will be executed. Else if, now the syntax of else if is you write else and you with space you need to write if. The two keywords are which you have to use together, else space if, and then you put conditions in bracket, and then you again start with the opening and closing curly brackets. So you have opening curly brackets and closing curly brackets, and within these brackets you have to write the code which you want to execute. So whenever the condition will be true, the condition which you are mentioning in else if, then this code will be executed. Now you can also write if and else if together, in which now conditions 1 is true, then this code where we have the condition 1 and we have a else if condition 2. So if condition 1 will be true, then this action 1 will be taken. That means whatever the code you will write between these brackets, so each statement, and then it will be executed. So, and let's say condition is whatever condition we are printing, the condition is returning false, in that case it will go for the next condition, next line of the code, and we have else if condition, in that condition 2 will be true, then this action 2 code will be executed. So whatever the code we will be writing in this else if brackets, the curly brackets, that code will be executed. Apart from if and else, we have a switch statement which is used for us conditions as well in JavaScript. The syntax of switch statement is start with the switch keyword, and then you put an expression in brackets, and then you put opening and closing curly brackets. You write different possible cases for the value of expression. So if you start with the case, that means a case keyword, and each expected value then colon, and then you put the code which you want to execute, and now after that you have to write break keyword. So I have not written in the particular code in this example, but after every case you have to use break keyword. Now break is something which is used in JavaScript, so if you do not want to execute further lines of code, in that case you can use a break. So for example, if we got statement matched, so if case A got the same value, that means it is going to run the code written in the case A, and if you are putting a break, then it will not go for other cases. So similarly, it will keep on checking all the values of whatever values you are expect thing in the expression that could mention in the code. We have a case B. Let's say you are expecting three values or maybe just two values A and B, and if nothing is being written from that expression, in that case you would use default. So default, then whatever the code you want to execute, A will not be found, B will not found. In that case, then the code which is written in the default case will be executed. Let's understand with an example, with practical example. So let's say we have a variable where A is equal to 100, ended with semicolon, and you have to print maybe some value, maybe a string, that if it is more than 100. So how you achieve, maybe it's a requirement of your program. So we have a equal to 200, and if A is more than 100, then it should be printing something else, not something else, not. So what we'll do, I'll start with if, because we are just checking the condition and we want to check the condition if it's a true. If it's a true, it should print the value. So in that case, I will start with the if condition and open the braces, and I will try to declare a where A is greater than 100, and I will put only curly brackets. Then I'll try to print a gs.print of and in the string section, I will just write A is more greater than 100. So close the braces and end it with semicolon. So if I will execute it will print something as of now. You can see it 100. You can see it 100, but not more than 100. So it will execute, it will print something as of now. You can see it is 100, but it is not more than 100. So let's try to execute and run this script. I'll run the script. Here you can see, if I have run the script, I have not got any result after running the script, because condition is not matched, because this returning false. A is not greater than 100, it's not more than 100. So in that case, what I will do, let's make it it's 101. A is equal to, let's make it as 101. And this time this will return a true. This is how you write if statement. So if you are writing this keyword, if we are writing the condition, and the condition is if, as we can see it here, we have declared the if condition. If this is true, then it will return the value. This is returning value. I just commented in if condition. This should execute, and this code will be printing something that is more than 100. And this time, if I will try to run the script, here you can see it. We got the result that condition is satisfied, and we are getting the output as A is more greater than 100. Yeah, more or greater, it's output as we want. We can choose it. That's the reason I'm getting the output. Now let's say we want to print something else. Let's say if A is not more than 100, then it should print less than 100. So if I come over here, in that case, whatever statement I have to use, so in that case, I will use a else statement on the next line. You can declare a else statement and open that braces. So in this script, so you can try to print gs.print A is less than 100. This means, so when the condition A is not satisfied, then this will print the result as A is less than 100. So once we declared it, now I will run the code. This will definitely print this particular output, that is the first one, because as we have not changed any if condition on here. This particular output again behind it, because it is returning true, and if it is false, then it should print one, that is how else the statement work. So here it is returning the true, then here it is for the false, and we already have a value more than 100. So if I run this script once again, so you can see A is more than 100 because as we have not changed any conditions. So let me go back into the script and we'll try to change the value of the A which is given, like let me give it as 99. So I'll try to run the script. So as per the condition, as we know in the reality, we have A is equal to 99 and A greater than 100, which is the condition. We know that A is not less than condition. Obviously it will print gs dot print that is A is less than 100. So if condition will be true, then only it will execute the code, and if condition is false, then it will execute the second code which is we have given in the else condition. So I'll just try to run the script. Here you can see A is the less than 100, which is an output, and the reason behind it, because A actually is less than 100. So if it, for example, over here A greater than 100 we have given, then it would execute the code and it will print the particular string, that is A is greater than 100. But as per our example, it is returning the false after the satisfied condition is running. It is printing the output, particular output, that is overall this A is less than 100. Now we had another statement as well in JavaScript of conditions, that is else if. So when exactly can use else if? So in that case you can use else if when you want to match any other condition. So maybe let me start over here, and what I will do here, I maybe just remove this one else, and I'll we can write with the else if. Then I'm putting A is equal to I'll use the one more condition, that is the condition 2, and I will give the condition, and I'll start it with opening the bracket, and I'll just declare A is less than 50. Let me declare it like this, where I'll, so if I'll run this code using a if else if this time. So if this will return true, then it will execute the first condition result. If return false, then it will execute the second condition result. In that case, I have 90, A is equal to 99, and I think what I can do, I can make it 101 once again the value. Here I will give it, so I can maybe, let's run this script and we'll check the output of it. Here you can see A is more greater than 100. A reason behind it, because the time it was able to execute this particular code which the condition satisfied in the first statement, and the value of A is not less than 50. Now if I have to execute this particular code, I will just changing the value over here, like remove the 101 and write, let me declare it with 49, and this code, now we can know that in the reality it will run the second statement, that is A is less than 100. So let's run the script and check the output. So here you can see is A is less than 100. Sorry, let me go back and change the condition that A is less than 50. So now the result will be, you know, as convenient we can see on the output. So if I run the script, so you here you can see it A is less than 50. So that's what the second condition, if it matches, and it is trying to run the condition of else if, and it is printing the value. So that's how you create different conditions, different conditions in JavaScript. So depending on the kind of use case we have it, you get from your customer. If I talk about the ServiceNow perspective, I think you will definitely use a lot of conditional statement in JavaScript in ServiceNow, while you will do the development, because I think in ServiceNow you will try to run lot of logic, because that's how overall scripting performs. You write a script on the basis of different condition, which you will definitely get in ServiceNow while performing coding in JavaScript. Now let's talk about another statement we have for a condition, that is switch. So let's say we will just remove this script from here. So let's say and we'll also remove this values, and we will try to declare it with 1. Now what I will do, I will just print some of the values on this basis of numbers I get for a, so for a switch I will start with this switch keyword, that is I'll just declare with the switch keyword and declaring the variable a, and open the curly braces. I will start with the case 1 now. So let me start with the case keyword, case 1 colon gs dot print of open the quotes. Now let's say it's a Sunday, and we will use the break keyword. We'll use the break keyword that is declared here, and on the case 2 we'll try to declare as a case 1 as we declared earlier. So case 2 is a colon, we'll try to print gs dot print of open the bracket, and we'll try to declare it as Monday, and we have to use a break statement, and it's done. So now on the case we have provided as just like case 1. Now what I will do, I'll just copy case 2 as well. So in that so here we can see it, we'll try to change all these values, like case 3 is equal to Wednesday, and case 4 is equal to Thursday. And we'll just change this as well as a Friday, Saturday, and we'll make it as Sunday. And we need to change the case number as well, otherwise it will conflict the code. So we'll try to change the number, it's case 5, case 6, and sorry for this, we'll try to make it as case 7. So this is for just for demo, we are using these details. So I think there's one mistake, we already used this case 7, so I think we have missed out one more this thing. So I'll just try to copy one more time, and I have missed one thing, that is Tuesday. Okay, let me change one more time my case over here. So I'll just change this case so it has to be in order, so that then only the printing value will be easily picked up by the switch. The basic mechanism of switch is, so it will try to check the cases one by one, it won't be checking at a time each. So it will try to repeat this switch case scenario by executing one of the cases and checking the required condition is satisfied or not. Once after declaring this, we have to use final which is the default one. I'll write a default one colon. So here we'll try to print gs dot print open the braces. So here I'll try to execute this is a Sunday, or we can mention it as anything, like I'll make it as this is like we can I'll write it as no day, and I'll just close this. because to make it a default, I need to show the demo. So I'll use like a node option over here. So I'll just declare it in the default. That's it. If I'm not able to get that value, so it'll try to print it as node. That's what the condition we have given. This is our switch and statement, and we have put our basically the variable where we'll capture the value, and it will check the value we have for this. A is equal to as we see in here, we have given A value is equal to 1, where we will capture the value and it will check what exactly the value we have for this. So A is, so that we have a 1 value over here in the bracket. So now we will run the script and we'll try to see the result of this. When I try to run the script, here you can see the result is Sunday. It is printing the Sunday because the value of A in the 1 we have given it as case 1 is, this is the case 1 which is executing, A is equal to 1. As per the variable we have declared, it is executing the case 1. We'll try to change it behavior, and we'll check the different type, how it is going to access. So let me declare A is equal to 0 and try to print this script. So we know that it should print the particular code that as a node. So I'll just click on it, run script. So here you can see the scripting which is executed because we have let's go back to the script. So here we have given a is equal to 0, and we have a switch A we are calling, and we are trying to search the cases. So on here we can see it, there is no case matched with the number 0. So that's the variable which shows the results that as a default, that making it as the output. You can see it here as node A. So this is how to create a switch statement in a JavaScript. You create a switch statement in a JavaScript. That's how you can do with the programming with the help of the statement and different statements which we learned, like if else if, and you can utilize these different statements, different conditional statements in JavaScript in ServiceNow as well, to get a different kind of or you have to run different kind of logic. So in this way you can use this switch statement and all those if else if statements on the ServiceNow and in the JavaScript as well. Thank you for watching video.